In this video, we'll talk about the zoom tool, which can be found here on the left-hand toolbar. And there are several choices: zoom in, zoom previous, zoom all, and pan. And so if we start by clicking on zoom in, notice that my mouse gets a small magnifying glass, and that indicates that we're ready to basically click and drag to indicate where we want to zoom to. And now we're back to a normal sort of mouse pointer, which means zooming is a single procedure. It doesn't repeat. You have to tell it again you want to zoom. And in this case, we could say zoom all. And zoom all will take us and zoom to to the entire design. If I say zoom in, I also have zoom previous, which will take you to the previous viewings, area. And then you have pan as well. So for example, if you zoom in and you're looking at a close area and then you would like to change to pan, with pan, I can click and drag to move my screen over. Panning stays turned on until I return to my regular rectangle selection tool. There's also hotkeys for you for the zoom commands. And if I look under the drop-down menu for zoom, or for view, sorry, that's where you'll find another way to get to the zoom tools. And in this case, it also shows us that zoom in is, the hotkey letter is Z, or Z. And zoom previous is F3, and zoom all is F4, and pan is H. So what that means to me is if I type H on my keyboard, I will go into pan mode. If I type H again, I stop panning. And if I type Z or Z on my keyboard, I can click and draw a box. So those are hotkeys which you can use. Now, depending on whether you're using Artistic Digitizer with a PC or a Mac, there may be other zooming capabilities that could be specific to your equipment setup. So for example, on a MacBook Pro, there would be a touchpad, and you on using the Mac version of the software, you would be able to use things like pinch to zoom. And so the Mac gestures are incorporated into the digitizer software. I'm recording currently using a PC. And on my PC, I'm using a mouse that has a wheel. And I often, when I'm making my recordings, will use that wheel. First of all, if I scroll the wheel right now, it moves my screen up and down. But if I hold my shift key down, it moves my screen left and right. And so I often will click my shift key and use this to adjust my screen slightly, or hold down the control key. And then when I scroll with my mouse, I can zoom in or zoom out. So if I hold down control, I zoom in to the area where my mouse is. If I put my mouse over here and I zoom in, I zoom into that area. And then again, I'm holding control and scrolling with my mouse. So these are other ways that you can zoom. And another way that you can zoom and you can see how zoomed in you are is down at the bottom of your screen. There is the, tells me right now we're looking at our design 78% of the original size. So if I change it to 100, that's like seeing the design at an actual size, and I could quickly go up to 200 or down to 25. So this is another way that you can change the zoom ratio of your workspace. So the main area I would say is the zoom tool, and certainly learning the hotkeys is going to make this much more efficient. So if we learn to type the letter Z and draw a box, we will quickly get our zoom that we want. So that is how to use the zoom tool.